Today we're going to start looking at the exciting world of layers within Photoshop, why you need them, what you can use them for, and hopefully to get your head around the whole concept of it, because we've had a lot of questions asking, where on earth do I begin with layers and why would I want them? There are lots of layers occurring naturally in the world, aren't there? If you think about it, you've got layers of rock and a cliff face. If you have a piece of bread with a layer of butter on it, followed by a layer of cheese, layer of tomato, another layer of butter and another layer of bread, you've got a whole bunch of layers which stack up together to become a cheese and tomato sandwich. And it's much the same within Photoshop's digital layers. To show you this, I've put my creative skills together and I have drawn you a picture which I'm hoping won't reflect too much light. If I can get this right, you should be able to see it. Here we go. We've got a little house and some birds and a tree. Three elements in one picture. But I have drawn each of these elements onto a separate layer of clear acetate sheet like this. The advantage of this is going to be that I can move individual bits of the picture around on their own. So on the top layer, if I can get hold of this properly, I should have my little, flock of birds. So if I move the top sheet, I can move the flock of birds to somewhere else in the picture. So now instead of being in the top, your top left corner, they're now over the house. You see, I can actually make them sort of fly around. On the next layer, I've got the tree. So the tree could now then be moved independently of the house. I can make it closer to the house or further away from the house. Hopefully you're getting my drift with this. All these things stack together, and the final layer is, of course, the house all on its own. Now you can split your pictures up in Photoshop into separate layers, and I'm going to show you why that can be incredibly useful. But the first thing we probably need to do is to have a look and see where you find layers and how you start to work with them. So let's have a little look into Photoshop here. Your layers will usually open on their own down here in the bottom right corner. But if they don't, if you go to the window menu and then come down here, you will find layers. There we go. We have a layers palette. At the moment, there's nothing going on in there because I don't have an image open at all. As you can see, there are some options already waiting to be filled in, and there's more along the bottom here as well, but they won't become active until we put an image in there. So first off, let me show you an image with an awful lot of layers in it. This is a poster which I made about a week ago to advertise our photography workshops, which we've started doing. I don't know if you saw that. Let me just close it again. Sorry. If you look into Photoshop, if you look into this area of the layers panel, when I open that, you will suddenly see, look at all those layers that have suddenly appeared. Every element of this image is on a separate layer, and as I scroll down through them, you can see there are quite a lot of layers there. Now, I don't want to fry your brains with this completely, but I just wanted to show you that it's really, really useful for making something like this, because you may want to move a particular thing around. So for example, just here, I've got this orange star with a price on it. If I wanted to move that to somewhere else on the poster, if I go to the star layer, which I have labeled here, click on it, get the little move tool, I can then just drag it around in my picture. So I could put it up there if I wanted to. If I want to put it back, just Control Z and it'll jump back again. For example, the picture of the two people down here looking at the camera. If I go into that layer, which you may be able to see, I have labeled people, I've given it a name, I could move their picture a bit to the right or to the left, or see what it would look like up here or something like that. The other power of layers is that you can stack things on top of each other. At the moment, you can see that the picture of the people is over the top of the words, improve your photography. So all I have to do is to come down here and find that layer. Here it is, improve your photography. And I can drag the people down and put them just below it. And now the words will go over the top of the picture. This is where layers will start to come in very useful. Now, this is more of a graphic design thing rather than a straightforward photography thing. But hopefully you get the idea. Let's just get rid of that one. And let's look, I don't want to save that. Let's look at a practical application for layers, something which you might find really, really useful. And a little explore around the layers palette so I can show you some things. Let's pop in a picture of little Layla here, giggling and laughing and smiling. Let's just make it a bit bigger. Hang on. Pull that down there. There we go. And make it a bit bigger. There we go. So you can really see it nicely. In our layers palette now, you'll notice there is only one layer instead of there being a whole palette full of lots and lots of layers. That's because there is only one image and it is flat. It is one layer, and Photoshop by default calls that the background layer. The background layer is always locked. That means you can't really do anything to it. It's considered to be the same as a JPEG, really. It's just a flat image. If I go to that moving around tool up here again and try and move that, you see nothing happens. And I get a warning which says, could not complete your request because the layer is locked. If we want to fiddle with this in layers, we have to create another layer. And that's where we're going to go in a moment. But first off, I just want to show you that you can set up your layers palette here, which makes it easier to work with. Up here in the top right, you may not be able to see this in the video because it's going to be quite small. There's a little tiny tab with a minute little black triangle pointing downwards. If you click on it, you get a whole bunch of options all to do with layers. There's new layer, duplicate layer, delete hidden layers, and all that kind of stuff. We're not going to go into all of those at the moment because that'll take hours. But I want to show you this one here, panel options. This is where you can set up how this panel appears. And it's really, really useful because if you have an image with a lot of layers in it, such as my poster, it's very easy to lose track of what is on which layer. Now, of course, you can label them, and I'm going to show you how to do that. But this is where you can control what this little thumbnail up here looks like. So you have the option of not having a thumbnail at all. You can have a very small thumbnail, a medium-sized, or a big one. If I just say OK, you will see we've now got a big thumbnail here. I don't particularly like the big thumbnail because it takes up so much room. I'm going to go back to a small thumbnail. But the most useful part is down here, thumbnail contents. You have layer bounds or entire document. If you're on entire document, then this thumbnail image here is of the entire document, the whole sort of image. But if you are working with just one very, very tiny part of an image, say just Layla's eyes, which we are going to do in a moment, or for example, my seagulls, my rather badly drawn, let's see if I can see them again for you. Here we go, my badly drawn little birds up here. If you had a thumbnail image of the whole layer, but all that was in that layer is those little birds, as you can see in a minute little thumbnail, such as we have on the screen, that's going to be tiny. It's going to be really, really hard to see them at all. By checking this option here, layer bounds, what it means is Photoshop will zoom in on just the contents of that layer. So if it's a full-size image layer, you'll get the whole thing. But if it's just one little tiny thing, it will make that fill the thumbnail so you can see what it is. If I click OK, you'll see that thumbnail get a bit smaller. There we go. And we're back where we want it to be again. So down here, there are some other tool options. Again, I'm not going into all of them. You can make different layers to adjust things within the picture, and there are reasons for wanting to do that so that you don't damage the original. There's another one here where you can create a group of layers. So if you had lots of text, for example, you might want to put all the text layers in one place so they're easier to find. This little one here, it's like a little sheet of paper with the corner turned over, that will create a new layer. If I click it, you can see up here there's now an empty layer. It says layer one, and there is no image in it because there's nothing there. That is a clear sheet of acetate with absolutely nothing on it. You can draw on it, you can do anything you like with it. So for example, if I was to get a pen tool here, what have we got, nasty green colour, and I start drawing a line on there. I haven't drawn it on the picture, I have drawn it just on this sheet of acetate at the top, which means I can move it around if I wish to. The other great thing, of course, is if I want to see what it looks like without that particular nasty green squiggle on there, this little eye icon here means I can make that layer invisible for a moment and then turn it back on again. Now, I just said to you, you'll be able to see what's in the layer, but because I've made that a bit big, it's, even though it's zoomed in on it, because it's such a thin green line, you can't actually see it in that thumbnail. If you don't want a layer, or you've created a layer but you think, well, actually that's of no use to me at all, you can either highlight it. You see, I can go from the background to our new layer. I forgot to tell you, sorry, that you can name it. So if I wanted to rename it, I just double click on the word layer and I can type green squiggle and press enter, and I have named the layer. It makes it easier to navigate and find your way around all the different layers which you may end up having. If you don't want a layer, you can just highlight it and click the little dustbin icon here, or you can get hold of it with your, you just drag it into the bin and let go, and it's gone. We're back to the original again.